Hi, you're here with Asha Bristol with the Style Center, and we're here at Beast Fest Fashion Show, where you will get epic footage and an interview with the creator, Reginald Smith. Stay tuned.
I got that money. I feel great, so maybe I might just search for a 9 to 5. If I try, then maybe I say I'm blind. So I walk up the street, with my fist, feeling that place is landing my miss. A pen and a paper, a stereo, a tape, me and Eric being a nice big plate of this, which is my favorite dish. But without the money, it's still a wish. Cause I don't like to dream about getting paid. So I drink into the books of the rhyme that I made. So now Pepsi, if I got pulled, get the studio, cause I'm paid for it.
Open up the door for me and call my name. Someday he will At all of our social media sites. You can like us on Facebook, check out our website, follow us on Twitter, or always feel free to email us. We are L3 Media, your number one source for all your videography and photography needs. Give us a call today.
I am here with the host of the B-Spec Fashion Show, Tierra Lee. How are you doing today?
I am excellent. How are you?
I'm fine. So, Tierra, can you tell us how long you have been hosting?
I have literally been in front of a camera since age 2. My mom said I came out talking, yes. But hosting, I've been hosting for about 5 years now.
I can tell that you're real comfortable with it also.
Thank you so much. I am. It's a passion. You know, I feel at home when I'm in front of the camera, so.
That's a good thing. You're doing what you love.
I think the outcome was excellent. They went over and beyond their expectations. The designers were excellent. The models were confident. I mean, everything was unique. It was one of a kind. So I think they went over and beyond their expectations. Everything was fabulous.
Okay. Okay, so for future references, if anyone wanted to get in contact with you about hosting an event, how would they get in contact with you?
You can contact me through email at Tierra Nicole. Facebook at Tierra Lee, that's T-Y-A-R-A underscore
brand?
Demi Black Designs. That's D-E-M-I-B-L-V-C-K Designs.
Okay, is there any concept behind that brand?
Well, Demi Black Designs is all about the upper level, the high fashion. And this season, I wanted to bring a real royal feel with what I displayed tonight. So I really hope people kind of caught that, because I'm trying to rebrand my brand, and I really want people to look at it and say, wow.
Okay, so with that and what you brought to the table tonight for the fashion show, what do you feel like the people got from that?
I think people understood where I was coming from. A lot of people gave me feedback and said, I see that you're doing like an ethnic royal collection, and that's exactly what I wanted to go for. And also with the Black Lives Matters posters, I wanted to do a tribute with all black models and black royalty and show people that black people really do matter, and we are kings and queens.
And I do like that you had that concept, because there's so much going on right now and it's so sensitive, and I like that you touched that subject within your modeling also. So with that being said, what do you think you bring to the table as a designer?
I think I bring a different aesthetic, a different feel. You know, in my clothing, I want people to be going somewhere. I'm dressing the person that is going to an event, that is going to somewhere really special. You know, a red carpet or a ball or something like that. But they want to be neat, nice, and couture, you know. So that's the type of person I dress.
Okay, so with that being said, with all of yourself being like high-end fashion, do you think your prices are reasonable?
I do think my prices are pretty reasonable. Everything is handmade, so, you know, it's going to be a little bit more. But I try to range everything from, I would say, $80 to $400, just depend on exactly what you're trying to get. You know? But I think the average person could afford that depending on where you're going.
Okay. And do you fit to all sizes, or you have a specific size that you stay within?
I try to fit to all sizes. I do fit to all sizes. So, yeah, that answers your questions. I fit to all sizes. I'll need measurements, and we'll get it done.
Okay, so also, I would love to get your social media for the people. So could you tell them how to contact you?
You can contact me on Instagram at demi.black.designs.com. That's demi.blvck.designs. And also, you can find my personal page on Instagram. That's Mr_BLVCK_.
Thank you so much. I'm here with Glenn. How are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm fine. So, give me some insight on what you think about the show.
I really enjoyed the show. I enjoyed the fashions. I mean, it was extreme. I love a lot of the designers. I mean, I think this was top quality work for the city of Memphis. This was really nice.
I believe so, too. I think so, too. So, I know that you are a designer yourself. Can you tell me what you designed in the show?
I didn't design anything in the show, but I do. I make custom-made bow ties, neckties, and I do a lot of other things for women. I do a lot of custom pieces, one-of-a-kind pieces. I didn't do anything in the show.
Okay, so with that being said, everything that you design is custom. How can people get in touch with you? Can you give them your social media?
Yes, I'm on Facebook. My name on Facebook is Glenn Kimbrell Allen. So you get in contact with me via Facebook, and that'll give you all the information you need for myself.
Thank you so much, Glenn.
Thank you for having me.
I'm here with Ken Cash. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm fine. So can you tell us the name of your brand?
The name of my clothing line is called Cash Ben, and tonight we show the 2016 summer collection.
Okay. Is there any specific reason why you chose that name as your brand?
I chose that name. When you think of cash, you think of money, so I'm a go-getter. The line kind of represents me and my individuality, so that's why I chose the name.
Okay. So what do you feel like you brought to the table tonight with this fashion show?
I feel like tonight what I brought to the table, I brought something that you've never seen before. I brought men with capes. I brought distressed crop tees. I brought like something different that Memphis wouldn't normally see.
Or they wouldn't normally respect.
Right. That also. So I was a little nervous tonight because I'm like, are they going to like it? You know, how are they going to receive it? I mean, I was backstage. I really couldn't see the reaction of the people. But when I came out, I got a lot of love. So I'm really happy that everybody responded well to it, because I knew I took a lot of chances.
So the feedback was really good.
The feedback was really good from what I got. So, yeah.
So you are risky? Are you team risky or team safe when it comes to your designs?
I'm more so team risky. I'm all about taking chances, going above and beyond. I think that's what fashion should be about. It should represent you, but also you have to take chances and try things you never done before. And just see how it looks, even if it's for fun, as long as you're doing something that you love, or if you're taking a chance, you never know what the creation could come out to be.
I truly agree. So, with that being said, can you tell me what inspired you to be a designer?
Well, as a kid, I always loved fashion. Fashion has always been something that I love to do. So I love fashion, and plus I'm a model. So like modeling and fashion, it goes hand in hand. So like when I would model creations, because I'm a freelance model, that would inspire me like, oh, I would love this top with this, or if this was cut like this, or if this was made like this. It kind of inspired me to reach out and jump out there and go ahead and finally do it. This is something that I always have wanted to do. I always wanted to do women clothes, but I kind of felt like men, as far as like the men clothes, it was nobody really that was taking chances. So I wanted to be that, you know, that stepping stone person to go out and finally take a chance with.
And I respect you for that.
So
to conclude this interview, can you give the people your social media to how to get in contact with you?
Sure. You guys can follow me on Instagram. That's KenCash2. Also, I have my own website with some of the designs that you've seen tonight. That's cashmenshop.com. A lot of the favorite designs of tonight are on the website, so you can purchase them now. I actually got like 2 orders already that people have bought, so I'm trying to, you know, raise that up.
Yep. Okay. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm here with Style Fairy Jenny. How are you doing today?
I'm doing well, Asha. How are you?
I'm fine. I have to let y'all know this is one of my favorites. We bump heads. We run into each other. But I still got mad love for you, girl. You are doing great things. So can you tell us about, I'm just going to jump into it because I know you rebrand. Can you tell us about your rebrand?
Yes. Well, we were formerly Genuinely Chic Boutique. So we have rebranded into J Chic Styling Firm, J Chic Styling Firm. So we're no longer a boutique. We still do sell clothes, classy, chic clothes, but we also offer styling services for men, women, children, and the home through interior design. So it's just basically we've added some further services to our brand. It's under our lifestyle brand, which is J Chic Lifestyle. So it's all about everything style under that one umbrella, and J Chic Styling Firm is who we do the styling through.
Yes, girl, come through. So with that being said, I know you have an anniversary. Is it today?
It
is today. Please tell us more about that.
Well, J Chic Styling Firm has been in business today 4 years. We are so honored and blessed because a lot of businesses don't make it past 1 year, and we've made it to 4. And so we are very excited and blessed to be 4 years in business in this hard world of being an entrepreneur. And I have almost a year ago quit my full-time job. So J Chic Styling Firm is my full-time employee. It's my baby. And by doing that, I've been able to nurture that baby and to bring it to fruition into doing what I love, which is styling. So just walking in my passion, walking in my purpose, and just enjoying the journey.
Girl, you got me smiling from ear to ear. I am so proud of you. Like, seriously, I am so proud of you. So can you tell us the new location that you have moved to?
Well, we are in the process of moving now. As you all know, we're no longer at the Winchester Road location. We left that location at the 1st of July. Our new location is located at Mount Moriah and Ridgeway. So that's 5910 Mount Moriah Road, suite number 101. If you're familiar with Kadeem Fashions, I'm moving in the same suite with Kadeem. We are going to have custom clothes by him, also in-house alterations, and my ready-to-wear pieces. So if you come in there and buy something from me that you're not able to fit, he can alter it right there on the spot. He can also make you something right there on the spot. I'm also in the process of creating my custom line, designing designing and also sewing that line. So I'm very excited to be teaming up and collabing with Kadeem the new location to me and the location that he's currently in.
I'm very excited for you. So can you tell us when the grand opening?
Well, we're working on that now. We're looking at within the next couple of weeks or so as far as getting the location decorated. And we want it to be totally fabulous. So not only are we going to have a grand opening, we're also going to have a ribbon cutting that'll be done by the Tri-State Defender. We're also going to be having advertising on the radio stations. We're going to deal with DeJuan Hendrix on that. So it's going to be really, really big. So I want it to be perfect or close to perfect as possible before I roll it out. So we will be keeping you all posted. If you would like to find out about the grand opening, about the new location, you can check us out on our business page, which is J. Chic Styling Firm, and everything will be posted there as far as all of our advancements.
Okay, since you already gave the website out, can you give us your social media as well?
I'm sorry, Asha gonna get me. My business page on Facebook is J. Chic Styling Firm. My website is www.genuinelychic.com. That's genuinely with a J. I'm also on Instagram at Genuinely Chic Styling Firm, and Twitter, Pinterest, any Snapchat, anything you can think of, we have it, and it's all under the J. Chic Lifestyle brand. So look for J. Chic, look for Genuinely Chic, look for any of those things, and it's going to point you directly to me.
Thank you so much.
No problem. Thank you, Asha. I appreciate you all, and L3 Media, y'all are so awesome. Y'all have rocked with me over these years, and I can't tell you how thankful I am to you, to Marcus, to everybody that's a part of the team, because without you all, like, I wouldn't have anybody on my media team, and I really, really appreciate all of the support that I've been given over the years from you all.
We're glad to be here for you also.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'm here with Reggie. How are you doing today?
Fine, how are you?
I'm fine. So can you tell me the concept of this fashion show?
The concept was to bring Memphis out of Memphis fashion. I wanted to give a little New York style.
Ooh.
So I was like, let's get Memphis revived.
Okay.
And that's where the name come from, Fashion Nation Revival.
Okay.
Revive, so, yeah.
Okay, I was going to ask that. So what is the name of it?
Fashion Nation Revival.
Okay. Yeah. So do you feel like you met the expectations of your show?
I know I did. I'm pretty sure of it. I've done it. I've done it well.
So how many, well, what, how would I word this? Okay. How many shows have you done prior to this one?
This will be my sixth one.
Sixth show? So do you feel like that you grew, like you definitely see growth in your...
A whole lot. Like, this was one of my best shows ever. Like, this was a complete change for me. It's different. I want to do something new, so, you know, try something more besides sticking with Memphis. So I want to bring it out a little bit, trying to test myself and see how I do it. So it happened.
Okay, so can you tell me the designers that you had in your show and why you chose those designers?
You got Quiz Designs, Immortal Ink, J. Chic, Fetish Life, Cash Clothing, Cash Men Clothing, and Demetrius, Demi Black. I chose those designers because they're so, they're so underrated. So they fit the name that I was going for. They was down for it, so that's why I chose them.
Well, congratulations, and I thank you so much for giving those people a chance, because people are really underrated, especially here in Memphis. So with that being said, after this interview, we will have clips of your show. So can you tell the people what they can expect from this show?
Expect different. Just expect different. I'm at a whole nother level, so get ready for the second part of Fascination Revival next year, 2017. It's going to be amazing. Expect it.
Also, I wanted to ask, what is your position, and are you solo, or do you have a styling team?
I have a styling team by the name of B-Specs, B-Specs Agency. We do hair, makeup, designing, styling, PR, creative director, everything. And our audience is to make models bigger than what they are. So.
All right. Well, thank you so much people your social media so they can get in touch with you?
Sure. Instagram, Reggie B, REGI.BEE. Or you can go to B-Spec Agency at Instagram. You can do my Facebook, Reginald Smith. I'm there. Just hit me up. I have my own styling business as well, Style by B. Smith. If you need styling, let me know. Hit me up. Inbox me, DM me, email me, do whatever you can. I'm there.
Thank you so much, Reggie.
No problem.